I found love in you. And I've learned to love me too. Never have I felt that I could be all that you see. It's like our hearts have intertwined into the perfect harmony. This is why I love you. This is why I love you, because you love me. You love me. This is why I love you. Ooh, this is why I love you, because you love me.
Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear with each other and forgive one another if you have grievance against the other. Forgive as the Lord forgave you. And over all these virtues, put on love, which binds all of them together in perfect unity. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body you have been called to peace, and be thankful. Take these virtues listed within this passage to heart. Take them with you into your marriage, and hold on to them throughout your life together. Each of these has value in itself, but taken together they will give you a life of enduring joy. Compassion. This enables you to look through the eyes of the other person, to see your spouse like Jesus sees them. Feel what they feel. Respond with caring understanding instead of with judgment. Kindness. This is offering sweet, encouraging words and deeds on the other's behalf, even in the midst of a busy and a chaotic life. Allow yourself to regularly be overwhelmed with love for your mate, and allow that to flow through your words and your actions toward them. Humility. This is giving up the freedom to always win or be right. She's always right. But instead, be the first to apologize and seek reconciliation. Gentleness. Keep your heart soft towards your lover. Rid yourself of bitterness and anger. Replace them with mercy and grace. Patience. Probably the most important of these five. Forever remember that the other person is not you, and celebrate your differences instead of allowing them to become a source of frustration. Forgiveness will be your greatest ally. It will be the source of continuing joy and deepest intimacy. Love, unselfish love, sacrificial love, will bind you in a mysterious and magnificent way. Through love, you meld into something more wonderful, more complete than you could ever be alone. The peace that Christ offers you within marriage is something greater than our minds can comprehend. But you must remember that no peace is obtained without struggle. In the midst of difficulty, look to Jesus and look to each other, and you will find assuredness, even in the midst of life's greatest storms. Let thankfulness reign in your home. Remember to enjoy the little things and never take the simple joys for granted. We give thanks to God the Father through our Lord Jesus Christ for your amazing life of marriage. Continue to do this, always. Mike and Soraya, the two of you have made a very serious and important decision in choosing to marry each other today. You are entering into a sacred agreement as partners in life. The quality of your marriage will reflect what you put into nurturing this relationship. You have the opportunity to go forward from this day to create a faithful, kind, and tender relationship. As your family and friends, we bless you today. But it is up to you to keep the blessings flowing throughout your lives together. We wish for you the wisdom, compassion, and faithfulness to create a peaceful sanctuary in which you can both grow in your love. Mike, do you understand and accept this responsibility? And do you pledge to do your very best each day, by the power of God, to create a loving, healthy, and God-honoring marriage? Soraya, do Do you understand and accept this responsibility? And do you pledge to do your very best each day by the power that God gives to create a loving, healthy, and God-honoring marriage? Mike and Soraya, the vows that you take today, you make to God and to each other. May they guide you throughout your lives together and make you one. Mike, please repeat after me. Soraya, I love you.
Soraya, I love you.
With all of my heart.
With all of my heart.
And will continue to love you.
And will continue to love you.
Selflessly.
Selflessly.
And with full devotion.
And with full devotion.
With joy.
With joy.
I take you as my wife.
I take you as my wife.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
I will stand.
I will stand.
United with you.
United with you.
No matter what life brings.
No matter what life brings.
In good times.
In good times.
In difficult times.
In difficult times.
In rich times.
In rich times.
And when things are tough.
And when things are tough.
I will be there for you.
I will be there for you.
Whether we are healthy and strong.
Are healthy and strong.
Or sick and weak.
Or sick and weak.
I am yours.
I am yours.
For the rest of my life.
For the rest of my life.
This is my vow to you.
This is my vow to you.
Soraya, please repeat after me. Mike, I love you. With all of my heart. And I am thankful to be your helper in life. With joy, I take you as my husband. From this day forward, I will stand united with you. No matter what life brings. In good times. In difficult times. In rich times. And when things get tough. Be there for you, whether we are healthy and strong or sick and weak. I am yours for the rest of my life. This is my vow to you. We're going to pray a prayer of blessing over the rings. Father, bless the giving and receiving of these rings. Help Mike and Soraya to abide in your peace and grow in their knowledge of your presence through their loving union. Lord, allow the seamless circle of these rings to become the symbol of their endless love and serve as a reminder to them of the holy covenant they are entering into today to be faithful, loving, and kind to each other. Dear God, may they live in your grace and be forever true to this union. In Jesus' name. Take the ring and place it on Soraya's finger. Repeat after me. Soraya, I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol. Of our unending love.
Of our unending love.
And with all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I am yours. Marriage is the mingling of two lives together. Each person is made up of countless parts. Your personality, your past, your hopes, your dreams, your imaginations. In marriage, you take all of those different parts of two individuals and you mix them together into something new and beautiful. In Mark chapter 10, verses 6 through 9, it says, "At the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one. Therefore, what God has joined together, let man not separate." At this time, please join your sands together as a life richly mixed and joined together, never to be separated. please bow your heads with me one more time? Father, we give you praise as you now join Mike and Soraya. We thank you for blessing their life together and weaving yourself throughout all they will do together. We thank you for providing them with a beautiful home and guiding them over the years as they fill it with their family and friends. Keep them and protect them, direct their steps, and lead them into prosperity and continual joy. In Jesus' name, amen. Mike, Soraya, because you have desired each other in marriage and have affirmed this before God and all these witnesses, by pledging your love and faith to each other, offering vows, and giving and receiving rings, I do proclaim that you are now husband and wife. Mike, as the beginning of a life of love, passion, and joy, you may now kiss your bride.
In you. And no other love will do. Every moment that you smile chases all the pain away. Forever and a while, in my heart is where you'll stay. This is why I love you. Ooh, this is why I love you. Because you love me. You love me. This is why I love you. Oh, this is why I love you. Because you love me. Stars have all aligned, and right now is the perfect time to say, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you,